Sharma.
I read. She is Satya. He is Leela. Okay, so the first point we have taken is how agile is practicing in our organization. So,
in my organization, actually, most of the projects, especially in my unit, we are implementing agile, that is scrum projects, and it's like may not be 100% following the scrum policies or rules, but it's like 75%, 80%, and all the projects were successful. Actually, by right from the startup cost till the retrospective, things all have been, artifacts or surveys have been followed religiously from my perspective.
Yeah, because as we have the specific roles for our product owner, scrum master, development team, so we are able to achieve, at least follow those, and most of them are success. But at the same time,
actually the commitment, what we are saying is there is no role properly defined. Now suppose there is a confusion between the project manager taking up SCM, he calls himself SCM, and he's not doing his project management, rather than he tries to mix both. There are confusions with the rules. There are confusions like what I faced is the confusion in roles not being followed. Taking just an example of PM or SM, and there is not agile properly followed. Suppose they say it is an agile. What is the agile? If you take up a daily task or daily activity, it's like you need to have a daily stand-up meetings, and then you convey your impediments, and once that is done, you implement it. And in the evening, we have on-site offshore scrum meetings. We have pre-scrum meetings, scrum meetings, and then we are having planning, it's fine. With the on-site, we are following in a regular way. But when it comes to the offshore, the daily stand-ups are not taken. They are as per the day. It is required today or not required. Or let's sit here and just discuss it. It's like we say it's just agile, but we are not being disciplined to the events. We have a separate scrum master for offshore. As I said, the PM. Or it's a project lead or tech lead.
Not driving the daily meetings?
No. It's I'm saying specific to the projects. If that was a small fixed bit project and they say it's a waterfall, but they follow again agile in that. We are having 3 months of project and we say no. Within 2 months we will give a demo and we will take a feedback and we will give the changes. Whereas it's a fixed bit and waterfall. So it's like a mix of culture between agile and waterfall, and a mix of culture between the roads, mix of culture between the events. So I see that agile is not being proper.
So yeah. This is your practical scheme. What reports is?
Report says about 70% of projects are being followed with agile, and they are being, whoever is being following proper agile, they are hitting the success. About 70%.
Yeah, here we are trying to mix our experiences with this. So, and we are trying to put why it is failing in our projects. Maybe we are thinking one is mixing up the roles, maybe confusing the roles and not following properly, and maybe lack of knowledge between the members.
What we are thinking of is when is the properly the trainings. If you are educating our teams, go for the workshops, know the concepts of agile, what actually should be the disciplines, educating the teams and encouraging for the certifications and all. We are seeing that the trend is increasing, and it may in 2 years or coming 5 years, all the projects will be mostly agile. So we are expecting
close to success.
Yeah.
And one more thing,
it may increase to 90%.
And one more thing is, without thinking whether our project is suitable for Scrum or not, first of all we need to think, right? If
what I see is there is problem without understanding whether a particular project is suitable for agile, they just jump into it saying that we'll go in agile mode and we'll finish this project. So setting up that deadline could be dangerous. It doesn't work if, say for you are developing a software for a nuclear fuel plant. So you can't go in agile. I mean, you may deliver it, but you know, it can make a matter of a difference when if it is a 32 bit or 16 bit, it can completely crash your system. So you should see, like, you know, specifically whether you are first, there may be a need for, I mean, I don't know if there is such a checklist for any project to qualify for agile or not, but then there should be a checklist for a project whether that suits a particular project or not. I mean, it doesn't, in most of, probably if you think from IT perspective, yes, maybe it suits a lot of those projects, maybe 90% or 99%, but agile is also being used in other industries as well. So when we talk, say, agile for a project, it could be any project, not just IT. So we have to have a checklist for qualifying a project. That's what is my
checklist is something which, you know, we have to have sort of few questions, like whether the PO is available all the time with the team. If he's not available, then Scrum will not go over. These are the three questions which we need to.
Not just the PO, there could be lot of, you know.
No, that is what it's one of the questionnaire which we need to have it.
Say for example that the Tejas project has taken 30 years of testing to make the right things for our engine. So, you know, 30 years is a lot.
The conclusion, just we need to think of whether that project is suitable for agile and the methodology also. Agile, there are so many methodologies, maybe Scrum is the one. Maybe suppose we have the production tickets, maybe that is the maintenance project. So whether you want it to apply, if it is applied, what type of methodology? Because the type of analysis should be made before making and going through, not just like jumping into the agile and Scrum. So that's what we wanted to come through for that. And so this is maybe currently it is happening, maybe one of that is just we are jumping into it. In the future, we are
having a PA role needs to be removed. Completely removed.
In the
future, we can work better.
But that you are contradicting with the future.
No, in the future, that is corporate. No, in the future, as knowledge and training start, now everyone is going for the Scrum, and now more people are interested in the trainings and certifications also, right? So, if the same trend is going on, and so most of the people will get the knowledge. As the PMs is the, like, past history now, PMs must be translated into Scrum Masters. In that way, they have the training. So, if we are doing it that way, if you follow,
they might be coming to the PO roles rather than PM, then they will understand the client, they will have better client interaction, and they will have better understanding about requirements rather than just doing monitoring.
Yeah, we are thinking in the future, because of this increasing, definitely that transformation will happen properly, and definitely we will move more success towards agile.
Yes.